Hello everyone, I'm Maryam Moshiri. The business news. Government borrowing fell by more than expected last month to £4.1 billion from £4.9 billion a year earlier. It was the lowest borrowing figure for the month of September since 2007. Borrowing for the whole year to date is 35% lower at £19.9 billion, potentially giving the Chancellor, Philip Hammond, room for manoeuvre in the upcoming budget on the 29th of October. The ONS says it's the lowest year-to-year date total since 2002. Now, these figures are important because they show how much the government has to spend and whether taxes will need to be increased. Yael Selfin is chief economist at KPMG and joins us now. Yael, first of all, tell me, how surprised were you by these figures? So good to have you. Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.
Now, let's take a look at some of today's other headlines. And shares in shopping centre owner Intu have soared today. It, of course, owns the Arndale Centre in Manchester and the Lakeside Centre in Essex. And it said it's been approached by possible buyers. It says a consortium had approached it with an offer worth 205 pence per share. One of the UK's biggest car dealers, Pendragon, has warned that new testing procedures for cars have disrupted sales. Since the 1st of September, all cars sold in the EU have to undergo the worldwide harmonised light vehicle test procedure. Now, the company also said that rising investment was also weighing on profits. It's now forecasting underlying pre-tax profits of £50 million for 2018. And around 13 million adults in the UK live in areas where at least half of the local banks and building societies have closed. That's according to analysis by the BBC. Figures from the Office for National Statistics show nearly 6,000 local branches have shut since 2010. That's a fall of a third. The consumer group, which called the numbers of closures alarming. Let's take a look now at how the markets are faring. And Britain's top share index is treading water today. We've had a couple of big fallers. Intercontinental Hotels Group, it's down after disappointing results. And the budget airline EasyJet share price is down around 6% after a broker downgrade. A lot of gloom in the travel sector right now. That's all the business news from me. Anita, back to you.
Thanks very much, Maryam.